That's a great thing to have a lady aboard with clean habits. Set the man a good example. I tell you, it's a model, like an inspiration. Well, I ain't had this old engine so clean in years, inside and out. Just look at her, miss. See how she practically sparkles. Myself, too. Guess you haven't never had a look at me without my whiskers and all cleaned up. I bet you wouldn't hardly recognize me. Works that much of a change.
I recently looked at the picture again for my daughter, who's will be 10. And African Queen, still a film that has an enchantment about it. It's exciting.
The African Queen sort of beat all the odds to emerge as one of the most wonderful movies ever made.
First and foremost, it's a great escape movie.
Seeing it during the restoration was a renewed thrill.
I'm hoping that people will rediscover it. I'm rediscovering it.
I love movies that can take you and you can forget about everything that's happening in your life.
It's just been a joy to see the filmmaking that was represented at a time when they were breaking a lot of ground.
And African Queen does that for me. It's a terrific film for doing that.
Film restoration is important on a couple of levels. I mean, certainly one is preserving the legacy of our motion pictures and, frankly, of the motion picture industry.
Our film heritage is important in the same way that painting is important, or Beethoven is important, or Mozart. These are our history and a record, a snapshot, if you will, of our culture.
There's some great motion pictures made in terms of their condition that they're no longer able to be presented in the best light.
My first involvement with African Queen was about 6 years ago, I believe. All the elements were extremely old, faded, and in pretty bad shape.
There may have been other attempts to do a restoration or preservation. It's just no one has made an attempt to restore this at this level.
In the early 50s, the process of the day for getting a consistent color product was a technicolor process. Unfortunately, every time we would do a test and get a new element, it just proved that we really needed to get back to the camera original three-strip negative, and it took several years, but we finally got access to the camera original negative.
Well, the Technicolor three-strip process took the image in through the camera lens and split it into three different color records, recorded three pieces of film in the camera, and then in the laboratory was able to recombine those into a very, very rich color motion picture record. So our ability to get at those original camera negatives was crucial in this restoration. Restoring a movie involves a lot of research, finding the right elements, the original camera negatives, if possible, in some cases a first generation intermediate print, something that had been made from that original negative, finding the absolute best picture sources we can find. Equally, find the best sound sources we can find of the film.
You had pops and clicks and crackle. The goal in this is to make the track as smooth as possible. So you don't want anything to jump out that shouldn't be jumping out and distract the listener from the experience of the movie.